back from that short commercial break. Of course, our bosses wanted us to make money, but guys, fear not, the topic is still going on and the show is still running. It runs from 8 to 9 p.m. So make sure you tell your friend Wabatanaba tuning in. We're already in to the vibe. So make sure that they get along on the train before it leaves, because it's about to leave. Before we went for the commercial break, the legend himself, Abada Tugamba, the type of reggae, so kotunyonyo, because again, I'm not going to pretend like I know these things. First explain, because you said he's gonna play for us a little bit, but before he plays, first explain to us what type of that Afrolinga thing you were talking about.
Yeah, the Afrolinga, the reggae linga is what I'm talking about. For those who know Lingala, it was one of those really African, the first Afro beat that we ever had, which is called the Lingala. Mwegwe mwita, umanyeno program ya Lugambo kansoke mkubaka. Tuli musaluni, ngabu mbanyi musaluni tukolera yo Lugambo. Na yemba demo voza anzijukize. Anyway. We always listen to Lingala from Congo. Good enough, we had our Ugandan musicians, you know, try to transform that so we could listen to more of the Ugandan music, but in Afrobeat, which is basically something you can refer to as Lingala. But when I came, because I'm so much interested in reggae, you remember after designing Lucky Dube, one of those artists who inspired me more to start, you know, doing what I call fashion concerts. And of course, when you're performing a fashion concert, you need music in the background, you know, to drive the show. And this is where we created what we call reggae linga. We are more into reggae remixes or reggae rhythms, but we want to fuse it with an Afro touch so we can, you know, reach masses in Africa. So Jaja Kaya will definitely sample us a few of his Afro our reggae linga tunes. He has a particular one which he created for me that basically talks about my profile.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, before you talk about the profile, Jaja, first take it away before Kubanga. I've actually been listening to Jaja sampling some off camera, and I told him when I heard, I was like, I really love music. So Jaja, first give us some of that kabit and latif, and I'll explain it.
Kambanjulire omurasta Lizaina latifu ea kukuka mokotunga, you know I know. Mojukire mumwaka enkumibiri mwesatu Lucky Dube we aja wano. Latifu yo ye yatunga echambale chilunji Lucky Dube omugenzi we yayimbira. We yaveyo yagenda mukwangeri enaija ya wangula awadi mokotonga. Kwe ya koma wo tugende maso kwe ya koma wo ya funasikala nagende bufalansa jia kukukira mufashoni ne designi. Kwe ya koma wo ya tandika Latifa Academy esomesa fashion ne design. Latifutunga Latifutunga Te yakoma kwebyo naia Jiyite rasman singa lweru naku Uruwabarasita monsiona Tuali tuliao kwe agenda Eyo mwa Amerika jeya tungira Mubanga ngali munyonyi Katia ze wano Atula ke kubi pia vyali na wo Latifutunga Latifutunga
That's right.
Wow, I think I'm gonna clap on behalf of the audience out there because wow, this I've actually listened to the lyrics. It's more of your journey from
That's
the
right.
day you designed for Lucky Dube. First, before we go any further, what was that feeling you had when you were designing for a legend like Lucky Dube?
People must know this is, I think, to me, it's one of those awards that I own, which is something you cannot compete about because it's one of those recognitions that I have. And designing Lucky Dube wasn't by mistake. When I heard he was coming to Uganda, this is the best way I could pay him. I was looking, I enjoy his music, I use his music. Every time when I'm creating, I'm listening to his music. Most of the designs are inspired by his releases. When you listen to his music, it can groom you, it can, you know, you grow up organized. Because he was talking about life.
He was speaking about life inspirational.
Exactly.
Moments,
so
the youth
he wasn't promoting any violence. He was basically teaching one love. And this is all about me. So when I heard he was coming, I was like, this is the best way I can reward him. Let me make him an outfit. It wasn't very easy, you know, getting him. But thank God, I managed to get him.
Actually.
Yeah, that's a very long story for this program. Yeah. Anyway.
Okay, so actually that comes to my question. We all know who Lucky Dube is. And like you said, he does not like inspire violence. He always inspires working together with
exactly.
one another.
Respect, actually,
people of different colors coming together. Yes.
Respect.
And my question is, whenever you go, for example, you have worked with different inspirational people in the industry. You have gone out and you have won awards in fashion. My question is, this one, I want you to be very honest with me. When people see you with that Rasta vibe, because they always have this satire that people who are having dreadlocks, you know, like those things, like they support violence. So haven't you ever been in a situation whereby you have gone to be recognized for your work, but you meet those kind of people that are scared of the look you have, like, has that ever happened or?
I think I haven't gotten that challenge.
Really?
Sincerely,
I've
only gotten that kind of challenge when I tried to hit on a girl and she was like, where am I going to take you with that hair?
Let's know we right now should be Mrs.
Yeah.
Latif.
Okay. Exactly. But I mean, I'm very glad that things have been moving on smoothly. Actually, when I put on my CV before competing for Africa Fashion Awards in Niger, when I put Lucky Dube, the first question they asked me, how did you meet Lucky Dube? To me, I think it was one of those points that were very strong for me to qualify me into Africa Fashion Competition. Because they are looking out for those designers who have really worked. And basically, to dress like a Dube,
is like
you must have worked.
Something, yes.
Exactly. So, my respect to Lucky Dube and all Rastas out there.
Okay. Yeah. I think I should also get myself a rasta.
But when you, if you had the song, the profile song Jaja Kaya was singing about, you know, going to America and sewing on the plane, which is the most viral video. Actually, you can Google man sewing on board. Man sewing on plane.
I think I've watched that one on
YouTube.
Yeah,
man sewing on plane mid-air. It's one of those most viral videos ever. If you just walked in America and stopped anybody, whether in a supermarket, have you watched a person, you know, sewing on plane? Somebody would be like, yes, I've seen someone. Is it you? Every time I would
think
ask.
You were the first.
Every time
you
I would
were the first
ask,
person who has ever done that.
Nobody has done that
plane.
Before.
Nobody has ever done that before. Nobody. The record still sits with you
and,
up to now.
The reason why I'm wearing actually this shirt is because Uganda has talent in America.
Wow. Okay, guys, we still have the legend himself, the beautiful model, and the musician in the building. Let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, you're still watching Saloon Talk.